A lot of people wonder, how do tornadoes form? The severe weather events typically stem from thunderstorms, although they don't necessarily have to. They are often defined as powerful spinning columns of air that extend from the clouds all the way to the ground. My name is ABDERRAHMANE, and today I will show you how these truly fascinating works of nature come to life. Tornadoes are some of the least understood phenomena in nature. Although no two tornadoes are the same, they need certain conditions to form.
First, we need wind shear. Winds high at the atmosphere level travel faster than the winds at the surface. There's also a temperature difference. The air higher up is cooler, while the air down below is usually warmer. This difference in wind speed and even direction creates wind shear, the interaction between the two layers moving at different rates. This causes the area between the layers to begin rotating, forming a horizontal column of rotating air.
This rotating air is horizontal, not vertical like a tornado. So you may be asking, how do we flip it? Well, it takes a thunderstorm, but not any thunderstorm, a supercell thunderstorm.
A supercell is a thunderstorm that has a strong updraft that feeds into the storm and fuels its growth, as well as a downdraft that expels cool air from the storm. Now, this updraft and downdraft interacts inside a supercell and creates rotation. This strong updraft interacts with the horizontal column of air and physically turns it to be vertical, creating a funnel cloud. The funnel of air moves down till it touches the ground, and this is how a tornado is formed.
Tornado may be a few meters across or up to 2 kilometers wide. It may be a water spout, a land spout, or a dust devil. They usually move along the ground at around 30 kilometers per hour. However, some have been clocked as a whopping 110 kilometers per hour.
To replicate this phenomenon, I've assembled a tornado machine which provides prime conditions for the formation of our tornado. The big fan at the top serves as the updraft inside the thunderstorm that sucks up the air from the tunnel cloud created by the wind shear, which is represented here by the rising gas caused by the sublimation of the dry ice. This mix creates a rotating column of air, similar to that of a tornado. Also, did you know that in the northern hemisphere, tornadoes spin counterclockwise, while in the southern hemisphere, tornadoes spin clockwise? This is due to the Coriolis effect. The Coriolis effect says that anytime you're rotating, objects moving in straight lines will appear to curve. So if you throw your paper airplane somewhere in the northern hemisphere in a straight line to the north, it will land to the right of the expected destination. The opposite would be happening in the southern hemisphere. An object traveling from the equator to the south would get deflected to the left. So what does this have to do with tornadoes, you may say? Well, the center of a tornado is characterized by low pressure air, while the air surrounding it is high pressure, so the air outside will try to rush to the middle. In the northern hemisphere, the volumes of air surrounding the center keep getting pulled slightly to the right, causing the entire system to spin in a counterclockwise direction. However, in the southern hemisphere, where the Coriolis effect pulls the air to the left, the opposite happens. Storms spin around the center in a clockwise manner.
That's the end of my video. Thanks for watching and hope you liked it. Oh, meanwhile, look, it's a tornado!